my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the mid-month love reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Aquarius. Let's see what spirit has for you guys for the mid-month of January 2018 regarding your love life. For those of you guys interested in private consultations, definitely look at the description box below. And let's get into your reading, Aquarius. Let's see what spirit has for you guys. All right, one more shuffle. All right, let's get into your reading, Aquarius. So I'm going to be pulling out three cards for you. Your first card is the Hermit card. Second card is the World card. Third card is, wow, Aquarius. You have nothing but major arcanas. Your partner's cards is the Four of Cups, the Hierophant, the High Priest. Oh, wow. Okay. All right. And your current situation is the Four of Swords. Okay, Aquarius. All right, my dear Aquarians. As a general or current situation, you have the Four of Swords. So for some of you guys perhaps recently broke up in a broke up or are giving each other space at the present time. The Four of Swords definitely represents not being in contact or not communicating with your partner or the person that you are currently interested in. Nonetheless, the Four of Swords does ask you to go within at the present time, as it is necessary for you to balance your energies, i.e. balance what it is that you genuinely truly want at this present time. Now, as you can see on your side, you have nothing but major arcanas. So this is a major transformation happening at the present time for all of you Aquarians. Saturn going into Capricorn is definitely ruling your 12th house at the present time. And that's what the Hermit is definitely talking about right here. The Hermit is talking about going within yourself, going within, and truly finding out what it is that you want and where do you go from here. You do have the World card, and the World card definitely represents the ending cycle, but the conclusion of a relationship. So perhaps for some of you guys that recently broke up, you're no longer dealing with the person, and at the present, perhaps there's a little bit of uncertainty because you're wondering if they ever will reach out. Nonetheless, the cards are definitely telling you that do not resist the change. Embrace the change. If this person is no longer in your life, there is a purpose as the universe is preparing you for something new. You do have the Fool card here, and the Fool card is definitely talking about embracing a new beginning, setting out on a new journey. Unfortunately, for some of you guys, it could represent a new person coming into your life. Now, the cards that are being represented here for your partner is the Four of Cups. The Four of Cups is they're not taking the offer, or they're not wanting to put effort in this relationship no longer. That's the reason why they're silenced, or that's the reason why they have pretty much dropped out of the map for some of you guys. The High Priest is definitely talking about them going, or perhaps in this situation, perhaps for some of you guys that currently or recently broke up, could represent that they were expecting marriage or that they're wanting a more stable commitment. And this was something that you were unable to provide, as right here with the Hierophant is definitely talking about a need for... Sorry, the Hermit. I keep saying the Hierophant for some reason. The Hermit is here signifying that there was a need for you to go within, almost an inner struggle going on as to where did you want to go from here in regards to the relationship. And this person pretty much didn't want to sit and wait for you no longer. The High Priest is definitely talking about, you know, having old beliefs, old values, the desire for marriage, the desire for kids. Maybe this was something that you were not interested in. Or it could also represent that, you know, it could be vice versa as it is a general reading. Nonetheless, the message is the same. There's new beginnings on both sides. Why? Because the Fool card is here and the card that is signifying your partner at the present time and how they view you or the situation at the present time is the Ace of Pentacles. The Ace of Pentacles is talking about a promise of something long-term or something long-lasting. So for a lot of you guys, it could represent that, in fact, the ending cycle, it could represent that you guys recently, there was a separation or both of you guys came to the terms of giving each other space. And within this time, you went within yourself and you came to the understanding that the only way this relationship could progress is through either taking it to the next level, which is to move in or to get married. And for some of you guys are going to jump in and take this opportunity. And that's the reason that Ace of Pentacles is coming out here. This separation or giving time off of each other was a good thing for some of you guys because it represents that both of you guys will be on the same page. Nonetheless, the Four of Cups could represent a little boredom in the relationship or the fact that they weren't talking to you for some time and perhaps they started talking to other people just to get themselves out of that anxiety, a type of energy. Nonetheless, they will be coming back towards you. Both of you guys will be on the same page and you will decide to move forward. And for some of you guys, marriage as it is being represented here. Now, for those of you guys that have been quite single for quite a while, you are definitely, you know, you've been single for quite a while and the conclusion of that is coming to an end. There's a new beginning here. And for some of you guys, it could be dealing with an earth sign. So an earth sign would be a Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. For others of you, it can also represent another air sign, which would be an Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra. And again, like I said, I do see that there is new, there is a new type of energy coming into your life. So again, like I said, for those of you guys that have been single for a while, the Four of Cups could represent that you were pretty much, I wouldn't say serial dating, but, you know, talking to multiple people until you come to the conclusion of knowing and understanding that you have more things in common with one specific person. For some of you guys, it could represent a Taurus. And you're going to want to, or they're going to want to move forward in getting to know each other a little bit better. But again, like I said, nonetheless, the message is the same. There is new beginnings for all of you Aquarians out there. And again, for those of you guys that have been keeping away or staying at bay with marriage, I feel that Saturn going into Capricorn, which is your 12th house at the present time, there's going to be major transformations going on with you guys. And perhaps for some of you guys, it's coming to the understanding that all this time you've been evading marriage or moving in with your partner. Nonetheless, you will come to the understanding that the only way this relationship could progress or move forward is if you actually do, you know, take that vow or commit yourself wholeheartedly to the person that you're with. And most of you guys will definitely be taking that leap of faith and jumping in. Again, like I said, if those of you guys that recently did separate and are no longer dealing with the person or your ex-partner, there is a new beginning coming for you, just like there's a new beginning for them with the person that could be much more suited for them in reference to giving them the commitment that they're wanting. Nonetheless, I do see promise for new beginnings as you have the Fool card and the Ace of Pentacles. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Like, share, and comment. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe. And we'll see each other in the beginning of the month. Alrighty, bye.